Hello friends, this is Neeraj Kumar. I welcome you all to this podcast on Hong Kong on behalf of KSG. So Hong Kong has been making news of late. The Chinese Parliament has recently passed a security legislation which makes it a crime to undermine the Beijing's authority in the territory. It has caused deep concern among the residents of Hong Kong because they believe that it ends their unique status, and we have been seeing a lot of protests in Hong Kong against mainland China. Hong Kong has a unique history. In 1997 July, it was returned to China after more than 150 years of British rule. Between 1842 and 1898, the British Empire seized control of three main regions which make up the modern-day Hong Kong. The final treaty was signed in 1898, and that gave Britain a lease of 99 years. Under this term of this treaty, Britain was supposed to hand over Hong Kong to China on July 1st, 1997. However, the Hong Kong's trajectory of growth and development has been completely different from mainland China, which all of you know became a communist country in 1949. It was a pure capitalist system. They experienced an economic boom, and they were home to a large multicultural international community. In 1984, the British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher and China's Prime Minister Zhao Ziyang, they signed the Sino-British Joint Declaration. It stipulated that Hong Kong, while it become part of China effective July 1st, 1997, but it will have a one country, two system arrangement. Whatever current social and economic system and lifestyle the Hong Kong citizens enjoy would remain the same for next 50 years. So they will continue to operate in a capitalist economy. They will continue to have rights to speech, press, assembly and religious belief. And it was designated as Special Administrative Region of China with its own mini constitution. However, they cannot elect their own leaders. It's run by a chief executive which is elected by a 1200 member election committee. Hong Kong in the last 60-70 years has become a key global financial center because of decades of an economy and a rule of law. And it has also served as a very critical conduit for investment flows into and out of China. As far as the US is concerned, the bilateral trade has been huge, almost $70 billion in the last year or so. And it acts as a regional hub for American businesses. Under the United States Hong Kong Policy Act of 1992, which has been in news for some time, Hong Kong is treated differently by US laws when it comes to financial transactions, immigration and trade. So US dollar can be freely exchanged with the Hong Kong dollar. This is a privilege which not many countries or not many currencies enjoy. So it becomes easy for American companies to do business. They also get preferential treatment on trade. What it implies is that there's hardly any tariff on imports from Hong Kong. And the US and the Hong Kong, between them, they enjoy visa-free travel, so business executives can come and go and do not require time period to get a visa, etc. If US were to remove Hong Kong's special status, all that would come to an end and many American businesses may choose to leave. And this is what has been discussed for the last few weeks. So there will be a export control over sensitive technology, what US has placed on China. They may also limit the export of American software and hardware on national security grounds. But these concerns are not new. There have been concerns that China is stifling public dissent, they're interfering in local politics. 2014, the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region saw an umbrella movement, which was a series of protests spread over many months, which called for a transparent election for city's chief executive. 2019, there was a proposed bill in Hong Kong Parliament, which allowed extradition to mainland China. Hong Kong residents believe that it violated the one country, two system, and the protests are continued even till the current year. Many businesses have become nervous because they see there's a likelihood of erosion of liberties and judicial independence, putting their businesses at threat. So in 2047, the one country, two system will expire, and the Hong Kong will get completely merged with China. What happens to the Hong Kong's basic law? Will China continue to recognize Hong Kong's autonomy after then? Only time will tell us. Thank you.